Good afternoon and welcome also from my side for the today's webinar. My name is Uwe Baumann. I'm the product and application trainer by Weidmüller in the academy. And the topic for today will be feature-orientated device connection technology for power electronics with the following content. At first, I will give you some requirements to the device connection technology, taking into account handling and functionality. Then I will come point two to the device applications for PCB terminals and connectors. Then some technology trends for electric power drive especially. And point four, I will show you some product recommendations for device connection technology from our app guide, from our website. App guide stands for the application guide. And at the end, I will give you a short summary of the webinar. So in general, connection technology is a very important element for the proper function of a device. We have in our product range four different ranges. We have PCB terminals for signals and power, then PCB connectors also for signals and power, then a typical feed a device through a panel terminal. That means this one is installed directly in the wall of the device, a metal or plastic device. And on the right side, you see a data device jacks for PCBs, for devices, and also M8, M12 PCB headers for IP65, IP67 device applications. These products we have for signals and data in our product range. So, point four, the requirements for the device connection technology. You see here, this is our OmniMate power device terminal connections with the maximum security. You see here, this is a typical push-in terminal with some levers. That means you put directly your wire in it, different poles we have, number of poles. That means this is a maximum performance with increased economic efficiency. Then here, different parts, different terminals, also a selected one, put it by slide together. That means you can connect a very wide range of cross sections, and all our products are approved according to UL up to 600 volt. So the next step is that we have also PCB terminal allows a 2-free PCB connection for conductors up to 16 square millimeter. This is a relatively new product. We have it in the pitch 7.5. That means cross section from 0.5 to 6 square millimeter wires, and you can use this for voltages from 1000 volt and 41 amps. For UL, you can use it for 600 volt and maximum 35 amps. And this we realized with staggered pins. That means you see here we have staggered pins solved on the PCB board. Yeah, we have created an architecture and pitch 15 also for the cross sections 0.5 to 16 square millimeter. And here we are going up to 76 amps and according UL to 66 amps. Yeah, we have two wire outgoing directions, one for 90 degrees, this is a 90 degrees version, and one for 180 degrees, it's coming from the top here, you see it on the bottom, and we have two test points to use a multimeter or a test equipment. Here you see connect the multimeter and the test equipment to measure directly on the terminal block. Yeah, this again is a tool-free release for the conductor by a lever. That means for disconnect the wire, you have to use this small orange lever. This is an integrated pusher. That means you see it here. And when you want to disconnect the wire, you have to use a screwdriver and press the small button down. Yeah, this is our OmniMate power device connector with in different versions. That means these are for applications for connectors up to 16 square millimeter. You see it here with the middle flange, the red middle flange, to fix the connector directly on the pin header. And we have different versions according the IEC standard, one for greater 3 millimeter finger safety, and for IT grids, 5.5 millimeter finger safety. Here we have the right pin header for this. I will come to this point a little bit later. We have also push-in connections also for the power connectors. We have some levers on it. This is a lock and relief lever, the red one, to fix the connector directly to the device. Yeah, this is a hybrid connector. I will explain it later, a little much more detailed. We have the hybrid means we combine energy signals and energy and also signaling coming from a motor, from a servo motor, and an EMC protection over pluggable shields. This is a pluggable shield here in one connector. This is a typical motor connector or motor connector for servo drives. So this is our complete range for power connectors, especially you see it here. This is used up to 18 kVA for cross sections, maximum 2.5 square millimeter. Then we have a range for up to 28 kVA, 6 square millimeter, and one for 52 kVA. And here you can connect a cross section up to 16 square millimeter. Yeah, for the IT grids, especially, I explained it already, we have a complete range with a higher finger safety from 18 to 52 kVA. And this range is going from 2.5 also to 16 square millimeter. And on the right side, again, you see our hybrid connector. Maximum power is 18 kVA. The power connector here, the special power connector, is used for maximum 6 square millimeter. And the signal connector, the small one here, also push in cross-section 1.5 square millimeter. That means we are using here the pitch 7.62 for power, and for signaling the pitch 3.81. Both are with the push-in connection technology. Yeah, a little bit detailed to the pluggable hybrid connector. That means this connector combines safety, miniaturization, and seal connection in one product. We have also here the push-in connector with open clamping unit. Here again, power signal and shield connections are made in one go. With this connector, you can save 38% less space on the enclosure front, from the front side. That means the EMC cable shield connection is connected automatically when you connect it to the device. And we have also a space-saving automatic middle flange locking for single hand operation. This is the red lever here, to protect the connector against vibration. Yeah, and we have finger safety according the IEC NUL standard 61800-5-1. So this another application, this is a pin header, a double pin header to connect to motor axis. We say in the book size design, and you see here, this is a servo drive, very thin, only 50 millimeter. The width is only 50 millimeters, and we realize a double pin header for the PCB board to connect a pin header or two different connectors for two different axes to the motors. You see it again, this is from the bottom side, and on the front side you have also different connectors for power and for signaling, but very thin, only 50 millimeters. So this is also new. We create now a power pin header for the SMT process. That means this power connector is used for THR through a reflow soldering. That means the customer reduced the assembly and manufacturing cost. That means this pin header is used for a current capacity up to 41 amps according IEC, and 40.5 amps according UL. And this is created in the pitch 7.62. Yeah, some recommendations on products for the production process for the automatic assembly. The positioning on the placement head. It's very important that the product has pick and place pads like here, or a very flat surface. You use also low weight components. That means when you have low weight components, you can place the component relatively fast on the PCB board. Yeah, feed off components meet packaging suited for automatic processes. We have our products in a tray, tape on reel, and some products in a tube. For the solar process, very important, we are using high temperature resistant materials like LCP, and we have optimized heat supply while we used standoffs. That means the pin header is a little bit higher from the PCB board. That means we have a little bit more space in the solder area. You see it here in the small standoffs in the on the bottom of the pin header, and here you have a little bit more space for the solder area. Yes, this will be some recommendations for the production process in total. Now we'll come to the device through panel terminal. This is a typical through panel terminal going from the from outside to inside the device. And this one is used up to 232 amps in total. This is a one, is a smaller one for a smaller cross section, and this one has also push-in connection technology. Yeah, this is one slide. That means this is a slide by slide product, and you can configure this by yourself if you want. Yeah, this is also tool-free wire connection. That means regarding the push-in connection. Now we'll come to the device applications for PCB terminals and connectors. I put some things together here, especially for drives. You need a lot of power connectors for the motors, for the supply voltage and the DC link. Also for PV inverters, the customer are using a lot of PCB terminals here, and especially for power supplies, where you find a lot of applications for terminals with the disconnect lever. Yeah, this is an example for a servo drive. This is a servo drive with the different connectors on it. On the bottom, again, two motor connectors for two axes, then a power connector for the power supply, then one for the DC links. This will be this area for the DC link to supply the power to the other servo drives or to transfer the generated energy from the motors to the grid especially. Yeah, and you have also connectors for network communication, some connectors here for the safety circuit, and on the top you will find also the positioning feedback, special connector for the positioning feedback to see what position the motor has. Yeah, this is an application in the field directly. That means this is installed in the cabinet. This device, we call it field power, is installed directly in the field for IP65. That means the servo drive is installed directly on the base of the field power housing. And with this unit, you are going here out to the different motors. And this is the mains 400 volt to go to the different sections, perhaps of an assembly line. Yeah, here you will find some success stories and references for the OmniMate power connectors and terminals. We have applications by Siemens, Rockwell Automation, LTI, Lenze, also Beckhoff for servo drive, Yaskawa, Japanese company, B&R, only to name some of this, especially for the motor connectors and power connectors. Yeah, now we'll show you some technology trends of electric drives, and you see here again our hybrid connector. That means it's a shielding connection without screws, fast and secure installation of the connector, and especially with installation of lots of shielded cables, reduce the risk of forgotten fixed screws and rated EMC problems. That means the traditional connector has two screws to fix the connector to the device, and when you forget to screw this, then you become EMC problems. Yeah, with our shield plate here, you put the connector in, and then it's automatically contacted and connected to the metal housing of the device. That means we have a better coupling impedance due to the large connection area. This is a very large connection area with some springs in it. And we are reaching up to 100 kilohertz. Approximately 15% less coupling impedance, and for a frequency up to 40 megahertz, 45% better coupling impedances than the conventional one. Yeah, here you will find some general trends between the control cabinet IP20 and the IP67 world. It's a typical one cable solution. That means this is a one cable solution from the device in the cabinet outside the cabinet directly to the servo motor. That means this is a consistent shielding concept for three-phase connection. You have the signal contacts, especially for the encoder and the motor temperature, and you can use also a hyperphase DSL protocol in the hybrid cable. Yeah, when you use the protocol to transfer the data for the encoder and the motor temperature, you can transfer over the two existing pins the signal for the DC brake of the motor to stop the motor immediately. Yeah, this is the thing, the different servo inverter here. Here on the left side, you see the different servo inverters. This is especially a servo inverter for three axis, one slide for three axis with three different connectors from Weidmüller. This is a complete system for 30 motors, and you see in the upper area, you have a very limited space for the connectors. Then we are going out with the grommet. That means the grommet is installed in the cabinet to go to bring the cable from inside the cabinet to outside to outer cabinet. And as you see it here, at the end of the cable, you have an M23 connector to connect directly the different servo motors. That means we deliver a complete cable harness from the cabinet, inside the cabinet, to outside the cabinet. Yeah, some solutions for the energy distribution. One moment. So, these are typical power bus systems. That means, especially for the brake energy, the recovery, that means the feedback of brake energy can be supplied. Here you see the power bus system on the bottom of the different devices and to transfer the energy to other different devices or back in the energy grid. This power bus system is used up to 600 volt, and the maximum current is 250 amps in total. Yeah, complex systems with multiple drive controllers. You have a daisy chain for such complex application. Relation to large cross-section is increasingly becoming a challenge for the installation. We see more and more applications with this power bus system and some general requirements to this trend. The customer wants to use bigger cross-sections, easy to use the DC link solutions to supply and share the energy between the drive controllers. That means these are the different drive controllers, and here you see the DC link and also the DC 24 volt supply, and this is transferred over the power bus system. So I have written down some general trends for signal and power connectors. We see a general trend for push-in, the spring connection for fast adaption, cross-sections up to 6 square millimeter, then vibration protection of the center flange lock with automatic locking. Here again, our center flange lock, the red one. That means this is a typical part for one-hand operation. That means you can disconnect the connector with one hand and not for two hands because in the area of the connectors is not enough space. And we see also a general trend for power connectors, especially for the hybrid connectors. Pluggable sheet connection for safe housing connection. That means EMC becomes more and more important for the devices. Yeah, here's some approvals and norms. I write down on the left side for IEC. We have the safety requirements and tests according to the IEC 61984. Then insulation coordination, standard insulation coordination for IEC 60664-1, especially for PCB connectors. Then we have this part for the PCB terminal blocks according the IEC 60947-7-4. Then we make also a heating test according the IEC standard 60 5.1.2-5.1. We make also a salt spray test according to this standard, and at the end for the power connectors, the safety of speed control drives according the IEC standard 61800-5-1. Yeah, the same thing for UL. We are using this for registered components according the UL 1059, including the CSA, and we test also determination of clearance and creepage distances, and also heating and short time withstand current. These are the tests, typical tests we make, and the unit is also tested with a device approval UL 61800-5-1 for safety of speed control drives. Okay, now we come to the product recommendation for device connection technology. Sometimes it's not so easy to find the right product for the right application. For therefore, we create on our internet a lot of different tools. We are using here the app guide, the application guide, to come from the application, the different device application, to a recommendation of the connection technology. Then we supply different libraries for CAD systems, and we have also for a selective program a 72-hour sample service. That means during 72 hours you have a small number of products in a box on your table. And we have also a product visit to create an individual product with a special printing, with special markers, in a special color. This is our product visit. And now we'll show you this live on our internet site. This is our internet site. I go to products, then I go to PCB terminals and connections and connectors. And you see here on this page, you find everything you need for the PCB terminals and connectors for the point one. The general information for this, you download some white papers. We have some white papers for especially drive controls. Then we explain the wire connection technologies. We have also written down some references, and we have a lot of small videos to show the different products in action. And you see here again, you can see also some small webinars, then PCB connection technology. We explain the soldering and process, some words and explanations about creepage and clearance distances. Again, what I explained, the norms and standard, and also some information about materials and surfaces of the different products. Yeah, the next thing is what I explained before is the product selection again, the product portfolio in total, then the app guide I will go in afterwards, then the product search according specifications, and again a selection regarding creepage and clearance distances of the different products. Yeah, point three, design in support. That means again the sample service, the EDI libraries here, the product configurator, and also some digital contents for the different products again. And at the end, you see our handling videos, the products in action, design and processing, how to use our products in the production phase, and some product changes, notifications, and so on. Yeah, the last thing, I will go again to the app guide to show in which way We go ahead. You go to the part app guide. I hope it's opened here. Takes a little bit longer. This is our app guide here, and you see different applications, device applications, for especially industrial controls, for drive controller and regulators. Here we have the devices for machine safety, analog signal converter, photovoltaic inverter, power supplies, radio base stations, heating electronics, also devices for building security equipment, some applications for LED lighting systems, and last not least, elevator electronic devices. That means what kind of connection technology you can spec in this device applications. And when I go, this is a topic, to drive controllers and regulators, you find again this small design, and the points are flickering. That means I want to see a motor connection here. Go to this point, and here you see a product recommendation for the motor connection. Again, our hybrid connector, some existing connectors here, and a terminal. And when you go, especially to the terminal, you find directly the name of the product. And here you are going directly in the product. And you see here the different products with the different poles, one pole, two pole, three pole, and four pole. I want to see the four pole version. And here on this side, you have everything for the product. Some small movies again, some data, and some curves here, some deratings curves for the product. And here you see additional data, especially the sample product order. From this product, I can order a sample. I have a PDF data sheet. I have a product configurator for this product. When I say no, I want to have it in another color, I want to have the levers here in another color, then you can configure your product by yourself. Yeah, so for the product coming from the device applications, and this is the same methodology also for the other device applications. Yeah, back to my presentation. And we have also a landing page for solutions for power electronics with this link here. And you will find additional things again for power electronics to connected applications. This is the link. Yeah, now we'll come to a short summary of my webinar. The trend for drive controllers is towards smaller devices is with simultaneously higher drive power, decreasing levels of protection of signals, higher frequencies, and miniaturization of the devices increase the requirements for electromagnetic compatibility, short EMC. Then the reduction of the wiring effort reduced possible errors, very clear. And the customer wants to have handling advantages of the connection technology, reduce the assembly time, e.g. center flange with self-locking one-hand operation, what I explained before. That means standard compliant plug connectors contribute to a large extent to a proper function and safety of a drive controller. At the same time, you have to meet the trend of miniaturization through hybrid solutions. Yeah, this is a summary of the content I've shown you before.